Hi, thanks for joining me in this video. In its normal state, you'll see two lines of information. The top line will show you the voltage, and the bottom one will show you either the amperage, the battery percentage, or the amp hours remaining. Another important indicator is the charging light. At the moment, it's charging. So I'm going to press the bottom key here, which now has gone into the amp reading. So currently, I am charging the battery through the solar panel. Very, very slight amount of current is going in. And if I were to, let's say, turn on another light, you'll see that the charging light will disappear. So if I turn on my lights, suddenly the charging light goes off and it shows that I'm actually now drawing about half an amp from the battery. So that's the function of the charging light there. It tells you the difference from when you're using power as to when you are actually charging the battery. Press the bottom key again. It goes into amp hours. This indicates the amount of energy I have in my battery, the number of amp hours I still have in my battery. Press it once again. When it gives a percentage symbol, it shows the percentage fullness of the battery. So right now my battery is almost full. You can also use the top key to cycle between voltage and wattage, but I don't find that very useful. But for some people, they prefer, instead of looking at amperage, they prefer to look at it in terms of watts. So at the moment I'm using about 6.5 watts of energy. But for most times, and this is the when you press this button again, the time indicator comes on, and this indicates the length of time it's been running since the time you've done your setup. So let's bring it back to voltage. So for most of us, I think we'll be using it with the voltage showing on the top and the state of charge showing at the bottom. When it's in the setting mode or debug mode, it looks different. You'll only see one line of display. To get into the debug mode, press and hold the set button. So now you're in the debug mode. To get out of the debug mode, just press and hold again. And this is back to normal mode again. So there are four things we need to do when we've got this to set up. You need to calibrate the voltage. You need to calibrate the amperage reading. You need to input the rated capacity of your battery. These first three things are done through the setting window or the debug mode. And the fourth thing to do would be to set the number of amp hours remaining in your battery. And that's the only setting that's done in the normal mode. So let's begin with voltage. So press and hold the set button. First thing you'll see is the voltage. You're now able to calibrate the reading. So you can increase or decrease this as you wish to what the actual battery voltage reading is. And to get the actual voltage, you'd use a multimeter. You just use your home multimeter, place it at the battery terminal, and you should match the two readings. The function of this is to take into account the cabling, the distance from the battery. So if you wish to set this up, let's say a distance from the battery, that distance would cause a voltage drop, and so that can be calibrated for through this way. So now let's assume that you've set the voltage and you're quite happy with it. The next thing you want to do now is set the amperage reading. The best thing to do is to do this at night or with the solar panels disconnected from your battery so you're not receiving any charge, and turn off all power sources to your battery. So in that way, your battery is now not gaining any current nor losing any current. So the reading ought to be zero. So use these two buttons until it says zero, like that. And you've now calibrated the amperage reading. The third thing to do will be to input your battery's capacity. Now, in our example, we're going to say the battery's capacity is 150 amp hours. So I'm going to have to change this figure 143 to 150. So I'm going to press this until it says 150. Okay, 150. All right, now that I'm all done, I'll press the set button again. And we'll see this page. And it's asking us whether we want to save the settings. So if we want to, it says N at the moment, which means no. We want to change that to yes. And press the set button to accept the changes. So we've now calibrated the voltage, the amperage, as well as the battery's capacity. The last thing we need to do now is tell the device how many amp hours remain in our battery. So let's assume I've got 150 amp hour capacity battery. It's new and it's fully charged. So that means I've got 150 amp hours in my battery now. So what I'll do is I'll press the bottom key until it says amp hours. And then I'll keep my finger on this until it flashes. And I'm going to change this figure to 150 now. Done. Now that I'm happy with that figure, I'll press the set button and that disappears. So now we're back in our normal mode. We read the correct voltage and it's telling me there's 150 amp hours of energy still left in the battery. If I press this button, it's telling me that the battery is 99.4% full because a little bit of current may have been used. And if I press this button once again, it shows the current draw of the battery. So I hope that's helped you set up your display. Let's check my battery's voltage using a multimeter. And the reading should be 12.39, not 12.41. So I'm going to calibrate the device now. And to do that, I'll press and hold the set button until only one line of display appears. The voltage, and I'm going to change this figure now by using the top and bottom keys to change that to 12.39. Okay, 12.39. Once I'm happy with that, I'll press set. At this point, I can also adjust my amperage if I wanted to. I could adjust the battery capacity at this stage if I wanted to. And now I'm in the save settings window. I'll change the N to a Y for yes to save, and to save it, I'll press the set button. So now that I've calibrated it, it gives me the correct voltage, and that's the beauty of this device. You can calibrate it for your setup. Okay, so this thing, the device needs a shunt. This thing here is called a shunt. On the left side, it's connected to the battery, the negative pole of the battery, the negative terminal of the battery. And on this side, you connect to the negatives of all your loads. So one of this will be from my fuse box, as well as the negatives from the two charging devices that you're likely to have. That's to say the battery charger, which runs off 24 volts, and from your solar panels. So this way you're keeping abreast of both the amount of power you're using as well as the amount of power that's coming into the system. The two smaller connections here is where the device measures the voltage and amperage.